presented by Church Tech U. It's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, what's new in ProPresenter 7.14? Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name is Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, why don't you join the over 11,000 people that have liked and subscribed to this channel? Some have even left comments and shared it. I know, crazy talk. So, one of the things that I love about the new way that Renewed Vision is doing ProPresenter, I say new, it's like 3 years now, is just the new features that we get from time to time. And recently they announced ProPresenter 7.14, and so I thought that I'd give you kind of an overview of all the new stuff in ProPresenter 7.14. So without further ado, let's head over to my computer and we'll take a look at ProPresenter 7.14. So here we are. There are basically three categories of things, and I'll dive more into them more specifically later in subsequent tutorials, but I did want to give you just an overview right now. So let's start up here in the upper right hand corner where it says live, and click on that and go on capture settings to start with. So once we do that, notice now we've got a place for preset. So what that means is you can go ahead and put in your address and your, of course that's not going to work because it's not a valid RTMP address. So let's try.
Hey there, aspiring ProPresenter Pro. Are you tired of getting tangled up in tech trouble? Want to impress your congregation with mind-blowing visuals? Well, look no further. Introducing ProPresenter 7 training at Church Tech U, your secret weapon for unlocking ProPresenter's full potential. Join me as I dive into the world of captivating presentations, smooth transitions, and jaw-dropping effects. From beginner basics to advanced tips and tricks, I've got you covered. Don't miss out on this amazing opportunity. Visit churchtechu.com/free trial for a free month now. Did I mention it's free? And revolutionize your ProPresenter game. Your congregation will thank you.
See if that will let me do that. And then I'll just put in a bunch of stuff here and let's see if I can save that. So I've got that preset, so now I can save that and save it as just whatever I want to call it. So that's one thing. Very helpful if you've got multiple presets. Maybe you send one place during one service, you need to send another place during another service. Maybe you from time to time go to a different location and their internet isn't as good, so instead of just changing the address and all, you actually need to change the encoding. So that's something else that is really cool, that you could save that along with it, so you could have a 360p 30 frames per second preset as well as a 1080p preset. But you might have already seen something else that we have there, and that is custom encoding. So we can change the encoding, and I'll dive into that a little bit more later. So those two things to help you with your encoding. But another thing that is really cool is, what if you could just have the ability to start and stop the recording or the encoding without going up here, clicking on this, and clicking start stream or start recording, whatever. So yes, now there's a way to do that. So let me show you one quick way to do this. Is if we right click here and go down to action, notice that there is a new thing down here, start capture, and you can select the appropriate settings and stop capture. So you could add an action there. And you can add those actions anywhere. You can add any other action. So we'll cover that later as well. So that's the capture and encoding settings, but they didn't stop there. There's also alpha settings. So if we go into screen, configure screens up here, I have a DeckLink Duo here that I have set up to do alpha. And the first thing that you should notice is, wait, alpha type has an additional choice here. So there are three. There's none, straight, and pre-multiplied. Pre-multiplied is the one that I've used for a long time. But straight is actually an improved way of doing that keying. And I'll show you that in a subsequent tutorial. But that's not all for alpha. Let me show you this. If I click here, this is just a regular HDMI, I almost said HTML, HDMI output. But what's this here? It says alpha key. Yes, now you can do alpha with HDMI. You can do alpha with SDI. That's not from the regular DeckLink Duo, DeckLink Quad, etc. hardware. So how do you do that? Well, you can actually enable it and set two different outputs, one for your key and one for your fill, even if those two outputs aren't those special outputs. So I could do two HDMIs, I could do an HDMI and an SDI and an HDMI, two SDIs, etc., just as long as they match resolution and frame rate. That's kind of an important thing. So we'll talk about that in the future. One other thing that I can't show you, but I do want to talk about later, is there is a beta for DirectX capability in ProPresenter 7 for Windows. So if you're on Windows, that should be really good news for you, because that, once it's reliable and out of beta, it might work perfectly fine for you, by the way. But once it does work perfectly fine for you, then that should lessen the load on the system, because it's using something that is created to make it kind of a better performing experience. Similar to on macOS, if you're familiar with Metal. Here, let me show you where that is so that you know, because I believe it's in the exact same place. You go to ProPresenter, and in Windows, it's Preferences. And then I think it's under Screens. And so, they might have actually taken this off because it has been a while and now it's just working by default. I think they did actually. So that's the last little bit. Not helpful for the Mac people, but super helpful for Windows people. So that's some of the different stuff that they've done to just make our lives better in ProPresenter 7.14. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course, so head on over to TDM.fyi/pro7 and quick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free for that course. Until next time, it's Paul Allen Clifford here, reminding you to go out and change eternity.